Prince Harry's made what we think is royal history when he took to the Whanganui River to paddle a waka today. The unique experience was part of the Prince's busy last day in the regions before heading to Auckland. Rebecca Edwards is on the royal tour.
A historic sight on the Whanganui River as a prince starts paddling alongside local warriors.
He's just going to be part of the crew. Special cargo, of course, but he'd be expected to do his share. Is that right, boys?
Yeah.
And Prince Harry did just that, using his very own paddle, gifted to him during his last stop in the regions. Earlier, a powerful porphyry. Welcomed His Royal Highness to Putiki Marae. The Prince addressing his hosts in Te Reo Māori.
Tēne aho, te mokapuna tama. I understand that there is a saying here. I am the river is me. You have offered me the extraordinary privilege today of travelling on the awa.
The Prince walking in the footsteps of his uncle, Prince Edward, here when he was teaching at Whanganui Collegiate.
Unfortunately, I'm not able to spend a whole year in Whanganui as he did.
This royal did have time, though, to spend an hour with veterans. 180 of the town's oldest gathered to meet him, including 95-year-old Ken Newton, who'd met the Prince's great-grandfather, King George, when he served with the Navy in the Second World War.
Because he asked the usual questions that I had some good answers for.
I had an idea he was quite a pleasant young fella, but I was pleased that he asked. He was just so natural and normal.
Despite the falling rain, it hasn't dampened spirits here in Whanganui. Once again, hundreds of people have been waiting hours for their chance to be charmed by this prince. Frenzied fans bidding the prince farewell as he heads north to Auckland for his last stop on this Kiwi journey. Rebecca Edwards, One News.